My name is Michael Nance, and I'm the East Area Right-of-Way Manager for TVA. You know, if you look at jobs coming into the Valley, one of the first things that a new company looks for is, do you have reliable power? So if TVA has a good transmission line that's maintained properly, then we offer a lot of companies, you know, an incentive to come into the Valley. So it could attract businesses. It certainly makes their power more reliable, you know, the more robust the transmission grid system. For TVA, that transmission line is reputation. It is actually a part of what our mission is about. If we attract jobs in the Valley, then we're supporting TVA's core mission, which is to bring prosperity to the Valley. Looking at transmission lines, I've seen them from 0.5 mile to 65 miles. What the typical transmission line would look like would be probably a couple of steel poles or one single pole, depending on if it's a single circuit or double circuit. You would have a wire, that's a conductor. You would have an insulator hanging down from a metal arm, and you would see it basically from pole to pole, and the line would, you know, have a little sag in it all the way through. They can look different than that. They can be steel laced towers. In the end, that line would go from a switch station to a switch station. One of those switch stations might be generation. It might be a substation for a local distributor. And once the electricity gets into a customer station, they use transformers to take it down to the voltage of electricity that a homeowner can use, and it goes out from that station, you know, to residences and businesses. So that would be the distribution line, which is a lot less voltage than a TVA line. When I'm out specifically doing my job talking to homeowners, is they think of the transmission line in the same way they would think in a distribution line. So if you're talking to them about removing a tree, they're like, well, now the power company's line out in the front yard, that wire's a foot from that tree. But transmission lines aren't insulated. A lot of distribution lines are, and it's just got to get within, 4 feet of that line. It'll jump over to the tree. And of course the conductors, made out of steel and aluminum. So just like any piece of steel or aluminum, once it gets hot, it does expand. So as you can imagine, in the summer when everybody's got their air conditioner on, it's 95 degrees outside. I've seen power lines that would sag in the middle, literally 20 feet further than where they would be in 50 degree weather. If you just run out to the power line one day in 50 degree weather and say, well, that power line's 20 feet from that tree. You may go out there in 90 degree weather and it may be 5 feet from that tree, which is too close. Everybody all over TVA is doing a huge amount of effort to keep that from happening. So it's not something that's taken lightly in any department.